हेलो, माय नेम इज़ हिमांशु एंड आई एम ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ आलमा वेटर। दिस इज़ अ माय फोर्थ प्रोजेक्ट विद कैपस्टोन प्रोजेक्ट विच ने बी द नेटफ्लिक्स मूवीज एंड टीवी शो क्लस्टरिंग। हेयर आई मेंशन माय नेम, प्रोजेक्ट टाइप एंड कंट्रीब्यूशन एंड देयर इज अ माय गिट हब लिंक। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस प्रोजेक्ट आई गिव अ ब्रीफ समरी ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट। नेटफ्लिक्स इज अ पॉपुलर स्ट्रीमिंग सर्विस दैट प्रोवाइड इट्स सब्सक्राइबर्स विद अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ मूवीज, टीवी शोज, डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज एंड ओरिजिनल कंटेंट टू वॉच ऑन डिमांड। द कंपनी वॉज फाउंडेड इन 1997 एज अ डीवीडी रेंटल सर्विस बट लेटर प्रोवाइडेड टू एन ऑनलाइन स्ट्रीमिंग मॉडल इन 2007। सिंस देन नेटफ्लिक्स हैज ग्रोन इंटू अ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर स्ट्रीमिंग सर्विस ग्लोबली विद ओवर 200 मिलियन सब्सक्राइबर्स इन मोर देन 190 कंट्रीज एज ऑफ 2021। दिस प्रोजेक्ट एम टू आइडेंटिफाई द पैटर्न इन द कंटेंट अवेलेबल ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म and the group them into a cluster based on the similarity in their genes. The problem statement we give in this project, this statement contains TV shows, movies available on Netflix as of 2019. The data is collected from the Fixable, which is a third-party Netflix search engine. In 2018, they released an interesting report which shows that the number of TV shows on Netflix has nearly tripled since 2010. In this project, I am going to do exploratory data analysis, understanding what type of content are available in different countries. If Netflix has been increasingly focusing on TV rather than movies in recent years, clustering similar content by matching text-based features. Let's begin. First of all, we import some important libraries like NumPy, Panda, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and some important libraries from sklearn. Then we load our dataset from my drive, and then we read data. Our load the dataset in variable name data. Then we see the first look of our data. Here we by this writing this code, we see the first 5 rows of our data set. Then we check the how many rows and columns are present in our data set by writing this code. In output we get this shows the number of rows are present in our data set, and this shows number of columns are present, how many number of columns are present in our data set. Then we get some information of our data set by writing this code. This shows the number of range indexes and the how many columns are present in our data set, and we also get the information which type of data are present in our data set, like integer and object are 2 types of data are present in our data set. Then we check the duplicate values by writing this code, and then we check the how many missing values are present in our data set by writing this code. And here clearly shows the director have a director name column have a 2389 null values and cast have 718 null values are present, and by writing this code we check the total number of how many total number of null values are present in our all rows in data set. 3631 rows null values are present in our data, and then we visualize the null values through this. This line shows the null values are present in how many higher number of lines means the high number of null value are present in our data set. Then we understand the our variable. This data dot column shows the all column name of our data set, show IDs, type, title, director, cast, country, data added, release year, rating, duration, listed in description, and these are the our column names. And then we describe the using the describe method to show the statistical mean of our data. Data dot describe, but it shows only the release year because other columns have a categorical data set. We checking the all statistical form of all other columns. We write these including all in under the curly under the brackets. It shows the all statistical form in NaN in the place of categorical data. Then we check the variable descriptions. Show ID means unique ID for every movie, TV shows. Type means identify a movie or TV shows. Title of the movie, director of the show. Then next we check the unique value are present for each variables. These are the unique values of our data set which are present in all the rows. Then we are going to checking the next data wrangling. Here data dot copy method we assign all our data set in a df variable. Then we check the df have any null value. Here again we check the director have a 2389 null values are present, we first handle the these null values, writing these codes, then we again check the have any null value are present in our data set or not. Checking the null value, here we can clearly say now there is no any null value present in our data set. Then we convert the date edit column to the date time, extracting the day, month and year from the columns. Next we again check the column names of our data set and the understanding the rating value. We count the rating value counts TV and then convert the rating into understandable format. Then we for more information, if you want to get more information, you have to click here. And if we are writing these above codes, what we understand, what we manipulate, have you done inside, you we find made a copy of the original data set HDF. Check the null value count of each column, handle the null value of filling in different value based on the column. After filling the null value, check the null value counts again and got zero. Then we are going to our data visualization, storytelling, experimenting with charts. Here shows the type of counts, matplotlib, and number of TV movies are greater than the TV shows. We can clearly see in the count float here that the most of the content added in movie, which are approximately 5000, nearly 2500 contents are TV shows. Top 10 country based total production, which is here are United States. According to the graph, a huge number of contents are produced in the United States, followed by India, UK and Japan, whereas Spain and France, Egypt and Turkey have a very less number of production. Again, then we check a total number of content written, added year, added month, added release year, and here we check, here we see the number of release year. Most of the TV shows are released in the 2021 and the most of the productions are in adult. And then we go next, understand the release year. The number of content released per year is increasing constantly, but it got a decrease in 2021. Most of the content on Netflix movie, which are approximately 5000, and the number of TV shows around 2500 on this platform. Then we count the unique director and the top director, and we visualize the top director. Rahul Campus and Jayant Sarkar producing most of the movies and TV shows, and followed by the Jayant Sarkar, Marques, Robbie and Jay Karras. Then we check the title, most frequent word used in the titles. These are the words which are most frequently used in the TV shows and movies, Christmas, Love, World. And then when we next we count the value and the visualize the off top 10 genres. Then we visualize the top 15 genres, writing these codes. And next we are going to cast and extracting the top crew members from the cast. And after this we have check the top 5 actor or actress of the Netflix. Anupam Kher has the highest number on the higher some value present in the cast column. It would have easier to get the more insight if some of the values in the cast columns are not null. Then we check the movie duration and we visualize the mostly are the 100 to 50 to 100 100 times are greater than minutes. These are the range duration of the movie on Netflix between 50 to 150. These also some movie 300 minute TV shows, the seasonal. Most of the TV shows have a 1 and 2 seasons, and the count or writing type of the content through these codes. And then after this we are going to check the insight found in these codes. Netflix has been increasingly focusing on the TV shows rather than movies in recent year. Most of the content on Netflix are added in the month of December and January. And next we check the type content available in different countries. And the US has the most number of movies and TV shows per the content, while India comes in the second place of the movie on the Netflix. After this we are done a feature engineering. There are no outlier in the data, so I don't have a handle any outlier here. While I clean the data completely in the data wrangling section, like handle the null values, then we go through our textual data processing. We write these code, combining the textual data to proceed with the NLP functions to remove the punctuation and stopper. We write these code and applying the function to remove punctuation. We write this code, and after this we are removing stop words, downloading the first we download the stop words and assigning the stop word to the variable and display. Here we display the stop words and the functions to remove the stop words for given text. We write this code and applying the functions on the text data. After this stemming the operator and text normalization function for stemming and lemmatization, and then we are applying a function to the text. And after the object initializing and collecting the vocabulary item with the vectorizer, converting the vector into array from the clustering. And after this we applying a PCA to reduce the dimension of our data set and calculate the explained variance ratio for each components, explain the variance ratio versus number of components. Here we can clearly see the above graph of the data with the 4000 components so cover 90% variation. If you have approximately 7000 components, then it will capture 100% variance, but it will increase the model of complexity. Then we check the shape of X shape and reducing the dimension to 4000. Then copy the transform data and performing the ML model k-means clustering above method, finding the k value through the above method. We write this code and plotting the above method curve. Here I can see sudden steepness after 6 cluster. After 6 cluster value within a cluster, some of the squares start the decrease and show the, and then still how the scores range of the k value empty list store. And then we write these codes here. After this we are cluster the 6 clusters. As we can see, the 6 cluster are the good enough. It would be more clear to select our visual, and then we visualize the Silhout score in the different k, plotting the Silhout score function, added the label to the plot and the shows the plot. According to the above line plot with 6 cluster, we get a good score which is really a good compared to different number. Then final k means model final, we write these codes, final model evaluation and creating a new column cluster with a cluster number. Then we check the first 5 rows of our data set and the value count of different cluster. After this we plot a size of cluster formed. Cluster 5 and 0 has got a maximum number of data points. Then we plotting our cluster in each data type, maximum content in all the cluster labels are movies, and we plot a dendrogram here. And as per the dendrogram, if we cut a tallest vertical line which shows the distance between those clusters, we will get 4 cluster with the 5 Euclidean distance. We perform hierarchical clustering algorithm fitting a hierarchical clustering, visualize the cluster, and then we nearly 6000 data points belong to cluster label 0, 992 belongs 1 and 847 belongs to label 3. After at the last of the project we draw a conclusion. Majority of the content on Netflix is a movies, but in recent year it has been focusing more on TV shows. Most of the content are for adults, while a very few content are for teens and kids. I implemented 2 kids model k-means and agglomerative clustering. I got a 6 cluster value with the elbow method silhouette score. So finally I choose 6 number of clusters as my optimal k value. This is my 4th project, which name is a Netflix movies TV and show. I have done this project with a very hard work, and I take the help of YouTube, GitHub and other social media and Google. Thank you.